Good morning, myself Poonam Yadav. I am from UGCDA CSR Indore. Today I will present one of the part of my PhD thesis, and that is frustration driven incommensurate charge and spin density waves in SrMn WxO3 and effect of tungsten doping. First, I will give introduction about charge and spin density waves. Charge and spin density waves are periodic modulation in charge density and spin density respectively, and charge density waves arises because of the electron phonon coupling, whereas spin density waves arises because of electron coupling. Spin density waves and charge density wave involve the development of superstructures in the form of periodic modulations, which can be seen easily through electron diffraction measurement and STM in case of charge density wave, and susceptibility measurement and neutron diffraction measurement in case of spin density waves. There are various system which shows high temperature strong charge ordering, like SrMn MoO3 and CaMn WO3, and in magnetite case it has been shown that the charge ordering is a type of charge density waves. Therefore, I have chosen the similar type of system, SrMn WO3. In SrMn3, Mn is in plus 4 state, which is converted to plus 3 state on tungsten substitution, and this Mn 4 plus and Mn 3 plus charge order and give rise to a phenomena of charge ordering. The polycrystalline simple sample of SrMn WO3 has prepared by solid state reaction method, and the room temperature XRD and neutron diffraction measurement shows that the crystal structure changes with varying the tungsten content. At the room temperature with 8% and 9% tungsten doping, the crystal structure is tetragonal, where the C axis is greater than A axis, A lattice parameter. Whereas for 10%, there is two tetragonal phases, one with C is greater than A and another one which is C less than A. And for 13.752, 16.25 tungsten percent, the crystal structure is tetragonal, whereas C is less than A. And for 18.75 and 17.75, the crystal structure is cubic. On carefully examining the XRD and neutron diffraction pattern, we can see that along with the main peak, there is a small satellite peaks in the sample. To visualize this, we have plotted the intensity in log scale, and these peaks are arising because of the charge ordering of Mn3, Mn4 ion. And we have fitted it with the modulation, using the modulation vectors for different composition, and the neutron fitting ritual defined neutron diffraction pattern has shown, and this showing that these super lattice peakings have fitted very well. We have also performed a low temperature XRD measurement, which shows that in SmW8 there is no charge or charge ordering peak up to low temperature, whereas in SmW10 at room temperature there is a charge ordering peak which vanishes when we go to low temperature, whereas in 13.75, 15 and 16.25 the charge ordering present at the room temperature as well as the low temperature, whereas in case of 17.5% the crystal structure is cubic at room temperature which goes to tetragonal at lower temperature with the charge ordering peaks. Here there is showing the modulation which changes with the temperature for each compositions. We have also performed magnetization study, temperature dependent magnetization study, to see if there is magnetic ordering present in the sample, and for each composition we are getting two magnetic ordering present in the sample, which is above the room temperature and another one which is below the room temperature. Above the room temperature, the ordering is due to charge ordering, where Mn3 plus and Mn4 plus charges are ordered. And below the room temperature, the ordering is due to antiferromagnetic phase transitions. We have also performed low temperature neutron diffraction measurement, which shows how the magnetic interaction changes by changing the tungsten content. And we can see that these are the magnetic peaks arising due to the magnetic ordering of Mn ions, and we can see that how these magnetic peaks are changing the tungsten component, and finally the magnetic ordering, long range magnetic ordering, disappears after the 18.7%. We have fitted the low temperature neutron diffraction pattern of SmW8 and 10, and we know that the crystal structure is elongated tetragonal, where C axis is greater than the A axis. Therefore, the orbitals are ordered along the C axis. Therefore, our spins are also aligned along the C axis in the system, and which gives us C-type antiferromagnetic structure. We have also fitted the SrMn 13.75 with propagation vector ½-0½. We can see that by using this propagation vector, this magnetic peak is fitted very well, and most of the magnetic peaks are fitted, but it's except these two peaks, and these peaks are not fitted until unless we have used the another propagation vector, that is incommensurate 0.12, 0.38, 0.5, which shows that this structure is comprises of two propagation vector, which is one commensurate and another one is incommensurate. Also, when we fit it using a single propagation vector, most of the spin are aligned along the B direction, as it is a compressed tetragonal structure. A axis is greater than the C axis, therefore the magnetic movement are aligned along the magnetic moments align along the B axis. By the Newton diffraction fitting, we get these three models, which were fitted very well with approximately same goodness of fit, and out of which this model fit appropriate according to us, because the spin is going toward the B direction with the incommensurate incommensurate modulations. In case of SrMn 16.5, the magnetic structure is fitted very well, only a single propagation vector, which is incommensurate, which give two magnetic models, which is centrosymmetric and non-centrosymmetric magnetic model. Both the fitting was very well for the both models, so it is was very difficult to judge which model is accurate on the basis of fitting. Finally, we have drawn a phase diagram which shows that how the magnetic interaction changes by changing the tungsten contain tungsten doping substitution. Here we can see that with 0% tungsten doping, the crystal structure magnetic structure is C-type antiferromagnetic, which changes to C-type antiferromagnetic structure, and which further changes to incommensurate antiferromagnetic structure with two propagation vector, and then finally incommensurate magnetic structure with single propagation vector. I have covered this this part of the phase diagram. So finally, we have prepared a sample which contains both spin and charge density wave, and the spin density wave arises maybe due to the charge density wave, because this sample which contains the spin density wave only show the charge density waves. Also, we have done a comprehensive magnetic study on the whole series with continuously varying the tungsten content, which gives the phase diagram of T versus X. Thank you.